I'm Justin Chang for the Los Angeles Times, and this week I'm reviewing Saban's Power Rangers, a new movie adapted from the hit 90s TV show Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
Please tell us one thing you did today.
Me and four kids from Angel Grove found a spaceship buried underground.
What?
I'm pretty sure I'm a superhero.
Cool. Pee in that cup!
It's the Avengers! It's the Transformers! No, it's Saban's Power Rangers, which is what we're expected to call this latest attempt to reboot the popular children's action adventure series on the big screen. Several thousand millennia after an epic clash between good and evil, five ordinary American teenagers are chosen to become the next generation of Power Rangers, super strong fighters who are tasked with protecting Earth from the evil Rita Repulsa. She's played here by Elizabeth Banks, dressed up to look like a cross between Poison Ivy and Freddy Krueger, and she evinces more personality than anyone else on screen by a long shot. As someone who spent more than a few precious hours of his childhood watching the TV show, I feel more qualified than usual to note that Saban's Power Rangers is a witless and cobbled-together piece of junk. And I mean that not as an insult so much as an assurance of brand integrity. Buildings topple, robot monsters called Zords clash head-on, a bunch of poorly computer-generated monsters fall over, and through it all, the Power Rangers show off their superhuman strength and nary a drop of basic human personality. All in all, the filmmakers have seen fit not to mess with a bad thing. I'm Justin Chang for the Los Angeles Times.